This capsule will give you a quick overview of the new functionalities that will decrease the time needed to perform bidirectional analysis. In the previous capsule, we demonstrated the advantages of using the template mode concept to uniformize unidirectional measurements. We'll now demonstrate how this concept, extended to bidirectional files, will help you decrease the effort needed to perform bidirectional analysis on a large number of files. EXFO Bidirectional File Format, also called BDR, contains information on two TRC files of opposite direction, used to perform a bidirectional OTDR analysis. This file format allows the user to have less files to manage and allow him to share results without having to share files of each direction. To create such a file, you first need to uniformize the traces of each direction and then generate the BDR file. As explained in a previous video, to help the uniformization process of unidirectional files, the user can use the template mode concept that was up to now only available for unidirectional measurement. Let's now demonstrate how extending the template mode concept to bidirectional files will help ease the generation of bidirectional analysis. Let's say we want to perform a bidirectional analysis on those 24 fibers that belong to a same cable. One way to do this would be to use one of the files from the AB group, adjust all the parameters, such as job information, span start and span end, and to add or remove events if necessary, and set these files as a reference and apply it to the other measurements of group AB. Once finished with the files from the AB direction, you would then have to repeat the same steps on the files corresponding to the BA direction, and then perform the bidirectional analysis. Let's see how we can perform the same operation, but in less steps and time. First, in order to match the files together, AB with BA direction, we need to make sure that the identifiers are correctly defined and that we have selected the right matching rules. With this new version of FastReporter 2, it is possible to define the identifiers to be used in matching files together. From the Matching Rule menu, in Project Setting, you can check or uncheck the desired identifier. For example, if you only wish to use fiber IDs and cable IDs to match the measurements together, you simply have to uncheck the other options. Once the desired matching rule has been selected, make sure that the documentation in each file is correctly set. For BA files, we can see that the cable ID is not the same as the AB files. Simply select all the BA files and enter the same cable ID as for the AB files. As soon as the matching rules is respected, the files should automatically be matched. Once all the files are matched, simply select them and generate all the bidirectional files. Select the options you wish to apply for the new bidirectional files and click OK. Now we can see that for each fiber we have a bidirectional file for each wavelength that were present in the .trc files. In our case, we have one file per 1310 nanometers measurement and another one for 1550 nanometers measurement. From the measurement window, we can see the information on AB, BA, and bidirectional analysis. Let's say we needed to remove event number 5 and add one between event number 2 and 3. To delete event number 5, I simply have to select it in the bidirectional event table and delete it. To add an event between 2 and 3, I'll select the AB direction, position the marker A at the location where I wish to add the event, and then add the event. As we can see, the new event has been added to the AB direction and have also been added to automatically bidirectional analysis. Working directly with the .bdr file allows the user to quickly perform modifications to the bidirectional analysis without having to separately modify each direction. This will greatly decrease the time needed to process large numbers of files. Now let's say that this bidirectional file is our reference trace that has all the events that should be present. As we can see in the measurement tab, the other measurements do not have the same number of events as our reference. Let's say that we need to apply the same changes done in this reference trace to all other fibers of this cable. With the template mode now extended to bidirectional files, we can simply set the file we have modified as the reference, just like we would do with unidirectional files, and then apply it as a bidirectional template for the other selected measurements. Now we can see that all the other measurements have the same events as the reference trace. Another great new functionality of this new version is the possibility to have different splice loss thresholds for uni and bidirectional measurements. From the pass-fail threshold configurator in the OTDR setting, you simply have to choose the uni and bidirectional splice loss threshold, and FastReporter 2 will automatically update the pass-fail status of each of these splices. Let's say that for the current project, we want to have a fail on splices having an average loss between 0.13 dBs. Simply select the wavelengths corresponding to the measurement in the project, enter the desired value, and click Apply. Now we can easily identify that splice that does not respect the acceptance criteria.